What's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of Community Voices. Hope everybody's doing good. I've run into the new year. Oh man, today is going to be a really good episode. We're sitting here with one of the star wide receivers for the Miami Dolphins, Robbie Chosen. Thank you for joining the show, man. How you feeling today?
I'm good. I'm good. Appreciate that.
Of course, man. I appreciate you cutting out time on your busy schedule to join us. I want to go ahead, I know you're busy, so I want to go ahead and get straight to it. You've been in this league for quite some time. I think you're going on 6 or 7 years now. How much has the game of football really helped you grow and develop over the years? And that could be as a man or as an athlete.
Yeah, I would say it helped me grow and develop a lot. Definitely from the aspect of discipline and structure and just overall like understanding patience and work ethic and a lot of key principles that I feel like are valuable in life.
I love that. Yeah, because that, I mean, like, you spend so much time crafting, like, perfecting your craft and getting better at it and like taking care of your body and all the mental. So I can just see how that already overspills into like the person and how you grow. In this time, have you also like, well, not in this time, but in this moment, with like when you look back on everything you've done in this NFL career so far, is there a certain moment that like stands out for you that you think about every now and then and like, man, like that's crazy, or that motivates you to keep going forward? Is there a certain moment in your career?
It's hard to like pinpoint one, but I definitely think like to the chapter I'm in now, getting traded last year to Arizona and going through that process, was very like I would say very like a strong point of adversity, but it brought out like a whole new like a new level and perspective for me.
Yeah, they always say that sometimes those challenges or those moments of difficulty, they make you or break you, but they also like just build you to be this new person to help you grow and get out of that zone. So, it's good to see that it like took you to that place where you're like, you know what, I'm gonna use this moment to be great over here in this moment. So I'm glad to see that there as well. One thing too is, it is also Martin Luther King Day. Each year, we always, we kind of take this day to, of course, like reflect on the work that he's done, and also just like the constant change that needs to happen still to this day. He did a lot, but there's a lot more that needs to be done in society today and in the world. I would love to know too. He had a big mission as far as his work and things like that, and a lot of people still carry on that mission and try to do that work, whether it's in a small capacity or a larger scale. When you think about like Martin Luther King Day and his work, what kind of crosses your mind during that day or when he's mentioned?
When I think about Martin Luther King, I think of somebody that had a vision bigger than himself and bigger than his life and unselfish, and just saw more than what was currently going on and somebody that was willing to fight for that and wanted to change in a positive to make a positive impact and change and togetherness and somebody with a mindset of love for each other.
100%. I can't agree with you more on that one. Also too, like I feel like too, I think we all it's easy to say, what about MLK inspires you, right? But I feel like the thing is, I think that inspiration is just instilled on us, like his work to like be better, have community impact. There's multiple things that he did that I think a lot of us carry and do on our own. I would love to kind of just know too, speaking to that, his push for community impact and social justice, things like that. How do you feel like you continue to push for those things on your side with the platform that you have?
I think I make a consistent effort. I have like very similar, goals and dreams bigger than myself for my community and communities, similar to where I come from to, just make things better and make things about what I feel like from my perspective, what life should be about.
I love that. I love that. The work. It's you put in so much work on the field, but what's even more important too is the work that you put in as a human being for the community to like, really give back. So I love that you could speak to that. Speaking of giving back, one thing that we are doing is we'll be donating 5K to the Amazing Wishes Foundation. For those who don't know me, let me wrap up my words real quick to the Amazing Wishes Foundation. Just helping to give back to the community and continuing our effort to impact the community. I would love, kind of love to know, like, you know, what about that organization kind of drew you to it to give back and to have an impact there with them.
Well, first off, thank you for that donation. You know, it means a lot. But it's just how, God bless her soul. My grandmother raised me to give back, and to help others. And my mother too. And just the family and my fiance and my uncle, my family just raised me to, give back, you know what I'm saying? And I know where I come from, the difference. Like just some minor help or a kid of getting encouragement or what a parent might be going through and things like that, how that might help, and it's just, I don't play the game just for like just winning and materials and things like that. Like I want to make an impact where I'm from and show kids that, for one, you can make it, but also help them in some type of way. And it could be the smallest of the smallest, but I just want to make where I come from a better place.
I love that. I love that. I want to ask one more question because I want to respect the time. If you fast forward, kind of like, you know, you think about your career. I talked about your career, you know, 6, 7 years. We're talking about the community impact that you've made. What like do you how kind of word this? What do you see your legacy being in the next 5 years? You know, you've done all this time. You've been an amazing wide receiver. You've already been giving back to the community. With that work that you've done, I know you want to continue to grow that forward. How do you see yourself taking that energy and taking it to the next years going forward?
Well, I mean, first and foremost, continue to grow as a man of God, and secondly, growing into a husband and becoming a father. And then, football wise, I would say hoping to become a Super Bowl champion and, all pro and, all those things I work for football wise. And then, in the community, really starting to expand like lifetime goals of expanding parks and creating more like activities for kids and reward programs and just staying impactful in the community and just rewarding kids for their hard work and trying to contribute in the positive ways and just remodeling and making things better, like making things more enjoyable for kids and showing them the right way, because the society and the world that we live in now is very distracting and misleading. And personally, I've been misled by false idols and things like that. And, I feel like I've been blessed with a gift and a cause to help make those things better and help show kids a better direction to grow. So, just overall, just staying positive and purposeful.
I love that. That last word you said is key. That purposeful, that purposeness. That is so important. That's finding purpose in everything you do, whether it be a husband, whether it be an athlete, whether it be a father, you know, and as a man in general. So I love that that last word is super key. So thank you for answering that, man. Well, man, I appreciate you joining us today. I appreciate everything that you do for the community. And I just, you know, thank you for cutting out time to join us for this episode of CB today, man.
No, thank you very much, and I appreciate it.
Of course, man. Thank y'all again for tuning in to another episode of Community Voices. And we'll see y'all next time. Take care.
Have a blessed one. Thank you.